Hello. Hi. Just thought I'd come and do a small video of my borders on the back. So start with Cosmia lucifer, which I don't remember planting here. Have three stems. No idea. Anyway, I don't remember planting it at all. This is Cosmia firebird, I think. Got it from one of my customers and it doesn't have the label, but it's very pretty and it's just got bigger and bigger every year. It's got a lot of stems. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 flower stems this year. 5 actually. There's some smaller ones here, so it's increasing slowly. Millennium, Morning Beauty, looking absolutely stunning just now. And Talictrum Ellen is still going. I was after this one for a long time. Finally I got it. And it's got a beautiful purple stem. An Astroemeria that I don't know the name of, which I grew from seed. It's just it don't come true from tree seed anyway, I don't think. A nice steel bee. It's just coming into flower, so flowers later than the other ones I have in the garden. Looks a bit like a hybrid of a Steve Pumila, but it's not. Don't know which one it is. A nice aster. The flower's quite early. Just starting to come. Hydrangea looking very pretty here under my cherry tree, which again this year didn't have any cherries. And that's how the leaves, it was damaged by the storm that we had in June. I just never got around to pruning it and taking them away. Actually, all the stems we pruned. Here I got a Petula nigrum, I think, in a pot. And it's starting to show some beautiful bark. I need to see if I can find space in the garden somewhere. Although I'm quite scared because they grow quite big. And I don't have room for big plants. This hydrangea was here in the garden when I moved. It's a mop head. Oh, this beautiful geranium is awesome. Looking very pretty. It's been flowering since beginning of June and it usually flowers all summer long. I've been collecting seeds, but I missed this one. Must come and get them. Geranium Patricia still flowering, and I have another geranium here, and I think it's an Oxonianum type. It's quite pretty. Artemisos Hollandaise needs pruned, but I quite like the seed heads as well. Parahibi Porlock still flowering. Actually, this is the second flush. I pruned all the dead seed heads and it's coming again. Oh, this beautiful buddleia is just starting to flower. I can't focus it. It is a cutting that I got from a friend. And when it opens, the flowers have a beautiful orange eye. The orange bits in it. And it's just beginning to flower and it's standing up so nicely. Yesterday it was drooping because of the drought. Got another Crocosmia here that I don't remember planting. Interesting. Okay. Equinox. Looking, starting to blue up, looking nice. That's I grew from seed. It's an amaranthus. Amaranthus hot chocolate, I think. An arecinus I grew this year from seed. Sanguisorba is coming into flower. I do have the name of it somewhere in the house, the variety. Agastache black adder. Is it black adder? I think so, yeah. Very nice, dark, big blooms, which I really like. A nice Halictum, Physostasia. This is a pink one, I think. I forgot the name. Got the label inside. Phlox Cocktail Sherbet. And a nice Penstemon. Penstemon Midnight is called. I got this one this year on my birthday. And then this is a beautiful blue Anchusa. I think it's, I don't know, maybe Italica also. It's been flowering since end of May. I mean, it's just so many flowers, and there's more new flower buds coming all the time. Just fab. Nepeta, Blue Dragon, I think is a Blue Dragon. That's been flowering for a long time as well. Heliopsis, Summer something, I think it's called. I like the foliage. There's a hoverfly. Enjoying a drink from it. Veronica. Oh, I got the label inside. This one as well. This is another one I bought this year. Pretty Agastache Alabaster. It's a white one. And I have a Salvia Clarea there. It's finished flowering. And this beautiful little daisy kind of flower. It's an Erigeron. Erigeron something. Anua, I think. Is it Anua? It's a new addition this year as well. And look at this. This is not meant to flower till September. Helianthus. So early, I feel, anyway. And then, oh, my messy corner is looking a bit messy today. It's got pots, bits and bobs on it. A nice Gaura. It's quite big, but it doesn't have a lot of flowers. Don't know what I'm doing wrong with it. The Scampsia. It's very tall. I like it. Oh, and this is my Lyx. They are flowering for the, I don't know, they've been flowering for years in this pot. I used to have a vegetable border here, so I left them in when I planted the perennials, and they come out every year and they look so nice. What are the name of this salvia? It's just coming into flower. Verbena Hastata, pink. And another Discampsia, yeah? I think this one is coming out. One of them is coming out anyway, it's too many. We need room for something more, something else. I've got so many plants I want to grow. Daylily, Sammy Russell, finished flowering for the day. There's more, 1, 2, 3, 4 buds opening tomorrow. I like them, they have lots of flower buds on them, so they'll flower for a long time. Now, nice and stilvy. It's not got as many flowers as it did because I used them for the flower arranging at the wedding, for the bride's bouquets and bridesmaids. I've got another geranium nodosum here that I grew from seed. Actually, I think I got it from a friend, not from seed. My friend Michelle. It's been flowering again since beginning of June, and it's keep flowering all summer, which I really like about it. This is the one I got from Caroline. It's blueberry ice. Nodosum blueberry ice. Very, very, very pretty. I love it. Rosa ballerina there. Veronica longifolia. It's finished flowering. They just didn't last very long at all, these flowers this year or anything because of the heat. Diascia personata, Campanula lactiflora, just got finished. The tiger lilies are coming into flower now. Some Nicotiana that I grew from seed. There's two colors here, a red and a greenish color. More Veronicas there, and the lilies are just coming into flower. The Clematis Viticella purpley one is full of flower buds and it's flowering. It's one was here in the garden, so I don't know which one. This another one more flower on Cnautia gigantea. Sidarcha is here. And this is another Sasha cell seeded here. More Ricinus. And a rose, variegated rose. So I'll finish flowering. That is Chisum Canum. Beautiful double Potentilla. And no, I'm not gonna say it. I can't say it. No. Monarda. There's some poppy seed heads I need to come and collect. There's some really nice poppies here. Another Ripina astata. And more tiger lilies and aster at the back. An aster at the back. And another beautiful dark flower chrysanthemum. This got flower buds just coming. Another Eryngium grew from seed, a very very spiky one. More Discantia. I got too many, which I need to take some of them out, make room for something else. And but they were great, they filled the gap when I needed. This is Epatorium cannabinum, I think. It's very tall. Again, I think I'm gonna get rid of it. I do like it, but I think it's not right for this pot anyway. It's just too tall. So it's gonna be replaced with something else. Salvia hot lips. A nice penstemon. And a lovely persicaria. And more lilies. Like lilies and a nice box coming into flower here. And still be here, it's almost finished. Serinte, I grew from seed. I quite like this one because it's kind of pink, the flower on it. And Verbena astata, or rigida. Verbena rigida. Very nice. And another lilies. And this summer hyacinth. I forgot the name now. It's got white flowers just coming. It's got lots of flower buds and I grew them from seed. I like growing things from seed. Look at this. Beautiful. Dark leaf. Stevias. Dark flower, I mean. I love that color. Another Gaura. This is Gaura the Bride. My son Aaron, he wanted to buy it. It's flowering well this year. Well, I think it's raspberries, autumn fruiting raspberries, and I have a nice blueberry bush there. And some bamboo that's in pot. And this is again autumn fruiting raspberries coming in a wasp. They're just starting to flower. And I did have some fruited, you can just see them there, just coming. I'm going to start eating them. They're nice. So that's this bit of the garden. It's a bit calm just now, it's not so much color in it. coming, having almost having a wee gap. Alliums are so far and far are fun, and they bring a good amount of color just now. They're absolutely covered in hoverflies. Hoverflies and bees, bumblebees. There's another hoverfly there. They're great for wildlife, these ones. Allium ferrocephalum. And they're very good. They come back every year. They, you know, don't disappear like allium, other alliums. So they're good. Good value. They're cheap as well. Another potentilla I bought years ago and I didn't keep the label, and it's in the pot and it's doing quite well. Clematis odoriba and Clematis fusca. And this one is almost finished flowering, but for my mother-in-law, she had it in her garden, so I don't know which one it is. Some Japanese anemones just coming into flower. Origanum. I love golden origanum. The bees love it as well. It smells nice. Euphorbia chameleon. And the seed heads on my Tulipa sprengeri that I got from Val are starting to open. So I think I'm just going to let scatter them in the garden, and hopefully they will sell seed like they do and naturalize like they do in her garden. That would be the hope. And this is Cosmos, chocolate cosmos. I overwintered in my greenhouse and from cuttings, and it's a good size. It's in a pot, so I can take it back in the greenhouse when frost appears. Francoa sanctifolia is just coming into bud. And this here is my Corydalis elata. So all the leaves, I cut them away, and it's just starting to grow back again. So now is the time to propagate it. So I think I'm going to lift a few clumps and start propagating to get some more. Is that a fantastic plant? And I want to show you this. I have some pots up here and I want to show you this. This is a species, petunia. Petunia grows in the wild. I was given by a gardener in the garden I visited. I just commented on it and he had some cuttings and he gave me one. And I had it for a while, but I stood on it. Imagine that. I broke it, but it grew back again. And now I'm watching, and hopefully I will not stand on it again. I'm going to go put it on the table here in the main garden. This is my middle bar garden. It's, I'm going to talk about this first. It's a bit messy just now, and I have my washing out, so you just have to excuse the mess. And look, I'm so excited. This is the Padleago from Gavin Sandgold. And it's got flower buds here, another flower bud there. So I'm waiting patiently to see it in flower. I have lots of these pieces on my geranium dreamland. And that is geranium Bob's panda and allium flavum. I really love them. Adelia coming there. This one is Spidens serenifolia. It grew from, pardon me, seedish here. And running from frosted explosion, Nicotiana. Oh, they smell so good. And I got Setaria caramel there coming in as well. My son loves alpine strawberries, so I have a pot here with alpine strawberries, and they're doing really well. A nice hosta that I grew from seed. Look at this. Isn't she beautiful? Looks like it's one of the ones with the small leaves.